Hello everyone, welcome, 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 my lovely people. This is so sad news, you know, a very big sad news that one Nigerian guy killed his baby mama in Germany. He stabbed the poor woman to death. This is so saddening. This is so saddening, you know. I don't just know what to say, but at least I will still like to voice out, to still give you my own point of view in this particular issue, because this killing of a teen is happening most especially with the Nigerian men living in Europe. Every time we hear this particular news, this one stabbed the girlfriend, this one killed the girlfriend, this one beat the girlfriend to death, you know, some they will even tell you that is they are dragging social money, that is why. Some they will tell you that maybe they have an altercation, so on and so forth. But this is so bad. This is a very big sad news, and I don't know why some men are very wicked. Some men are so heartless, whereby a woman that we have the urge to get pregnant for you, carry your own baby for good 9 months, that will show you that that particular woman loves you. You don't even have any right to beat that particular woman, not to talk of up to the extent of killing her. And I can't imagine whereby a man will be fighting with his wife, you will be beating your wife, and you will be using bottles, using knife to stab a woman that you know that she is powerless, she is helpless, you are more stronger than her, but still you will have the zeal to kill her, all in the name of whatsoever, selfishness, or maybe you are in drug, you are within the drug influence or alcohol influence or whatsoever. This is very bad. It is very bad. According to what we heard concerning this particular lady that died in Germany, that the boyfriend stabbed to death, I think both of them have some issues to settle. Yeah, welcome. Why or what was his reason? That is unknown to him, because some men that can't even hold their temper, you know. Madu, Sese, you're welcome. Please share. A lot of men don't even know how to handle their self, know how to control their self when they are having issues with their wife. That is very bad. So according to what we heard, we heard that both of them have an altercation whereby they have separated, and I think the children was with the woman. And the man have chances to visit the children. So I think they said that when the woman was in the garden with her children, then the man was supposed to come for visiting to see the children. So before you know, Vincent Nworu, you're welcome. Thank you. Before you know it, the both of them started fighting. And the most painful thing is that this particular guy that you know that you are more powerful than the woman, beating her with your hands is not even okay. But we have the guts to carry knife. Ah, God, this is bad. Carry knife, stab her, chuk her, stab her everywhere till she die. It means that you hate this particular woman. You never loved her for one day. Because I believe if you loved her, you will not even cause any harm to her. Not even up to the extent of killing that particular lady. Now, the lady is dead. I think the police have arrested the man already. And the children now, both of them will lose the children, because the lady is no more living. She's dead. And the children now, the government will start taking care of the children. The man now will go to the prison. What is your gain of doing all this? What have you gained in killing your own fellow human being, your own fellow sister, Both of you are from the same country. Both of you left Africa for a greener pasture in Europe. We all understand that here in Europe, the condition is so, so hard. The condition is hard that even sometimes we feel that even some European peoples, many of them want to frustrate us. We feel that at least they don't even want the good of us. Because if you see the way things are going in this Europe, you will know that to even live with a man or to even get married is the hardest thing to do. Because once you get married or living with a man, there are many things that you cannot do as a woman, whereby you can't even be able to get the income. And also, if the man also is not working, the man also is not bringing anything home, the family will be frustrated. And every day there will be quarrel, there will be angriness, and so on and so forth. You all forget that we understand the system that is being played in Europe concerning the issue of relationship. Even the people that we met in this Europe, we understand that many of them don't even want to see us together. They don't even want us to even get married. They don't even want us to be with our family. Always they will want one thing or the other for us to separate. But we that are in this condition, we forget to understand what is going on, for us to put ourselves together, to manage whatsoever that comes up, to settle our scores together without even inviting them, even giving them the go ahead to separate us. Everybody normally have problem, no matter what. No matter what. Once maybe you are married, or because it's your husband or your friend, even if it's your friend, even if it's your mother, even if it's your sister, you see these teeth and tongue. Sometimes they quarrel. But it's left for you to settle it amicably without you exposing yourself to the world. We understand. But sometimes there are some men that are very, 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 very useless. I call them useless men. Because those type of men, I think they are selfish, they are so greedy, and some of them are even psychopaths. They are psychopaths that anything they do, they don't want to control themselves. They want to misuse the women. They want to do anyhow. After everything that you've suffered for them, after every care that you gave to them, they will not even be satisfied. Once some of them will see that you have a child with them, they will start misbehaving. A lot will even be sleeping outside without wanting you to say anything, without wanting you to talk. But if you are the woman that go outside now to look for another man, now you are friending another man, that will bring big time problem for you. The man will start, fighting here and there, this and that, all sort of nonsense. Whereas he forgot that he is not the one that is putting the family together. You know, our parents back home, they bear so many things, that is true. And also, our parents back home, they have seen suffer a lot, and they know how to manage, no matter the condition. That does not mean that you as a man, we have to raise your hand on your woman. Because once woman tell you, say, I love you, she meant it. The woman that did not love you, like me myself, I normally use myself to give you an example. If I tell you that I love you, I love you. But if I don't love you, I don't love you. That is how it is. So I believe that a woman that did not love you as a man will never ever get pregnant for you. Because giving birth to a child is a very complicated issue, whereby a woman can even lose her life. She can even die just to sacrifice for both of you to have children. So a woman that tell you that I love you, and that particular woman have the guts to get pregnant for you, I don't think it's good and it's nice for you as a man to raise your finger on that woman. Not to talk of killing her or stabbing her or doing all sort of things. We have to change the way we do things. We have to change the manners that we do things. I don't agree with all this separation or maybe divorcing of a thing. But if your life is in danger, it is the right thing for you to do. Because if you are friending or you are with a toxicated relationship, whereby maybe the man is a drunkard, is a smoker, and even if he's a drunkard, he's a smoker self, he doesn't know how to behave himself when he's drunk. He doesn't know how to control his anger when he's drunk. It is better you leave that kind of man, because on a very bad day, if the thing still come up to that man, he might even pick something and kill you. That is the final thing. Every time you will hear that Nigerian man do this to his wife, Nigerian man, it's not only Nigerians that are in Europe. There are other African people in Europe. Joseph Morin, yeah, hello dear, you're welcome. Welcome dear. Visit Mwogu, keep it up. Thank you so much, you know. It's not only Nigerians that are in this Europe at all. It's not only Nigerians that are even married or that are even with a baby mama or baby fathers. A lot of African people, some of them said they will be the one to bring their wife. Some of them we know their wife in Europe, they will get married together. But we not hear all this kind of sort of nonsense, because some of those men, they know how to behave themselves. And also, their women also know how to respect their man. Know what is good, what your husband wants, and what your husband doesn't want. Even if you are in the hard time, that maybe money is not coming to the house, or maybe one thing or the other, things are not going fine, they will still have the zeal to still work together and also stand as one. But you see, in the case of Nigerians, many of them don't have patience. There is no patience at all, at all, at all. Once they see that maybe you are the woman bringing money at home, you now got pregnant, you are not getting that money anymore, the family will scatter. Maybe you are the man bringing money at home, then they will see that maybe you are not getting that money anymore, you are not working again, things are not going fine, the family will scatter. That is not what we call relationship. That is not love. That is not marriage. That is hatred. Because if you love each other, you will stand together as one. You will always stand together no matter what, no matter the conditions, and you will try to solve your issues, settle your scores within you, without even allowing the authorities or letting them to know what is going on with you. You understand? If you see now in Europe, every time you will hear that a Nigerian lady, this one called police for the man, this one called police for the husband, the man now beats the wife, all sort of nonsense. Because of all this, even the Europeans themselves, they are not respecting Nigerians' relationship or their marriage. Once you tell them that you are married, if you are a Nigerian, they will just be looking at you. I said it in one of my videos last time. They will be following you. They will be, you know, tracing you to know if really that relationship is working out, or if maybe the man is using you, or something is going wrong in that relationship. But for other tribes, other people, other country people, then nobody will even send them. If they tell you that this is their wife, they will know that really this is their wife, and they are going to be together no matter what. You see the single mother of a thing, a lot, the mistakes also come from the Nigerian men. Yes. The mistakes are from Nigerian men especially, because you will see some of these ladies, some will even stop working. They will drop their job. They will drop everything that they have to do just because they are pregnant for you. They love you. They will even try to even give birth to that particular child. But what the men will do is this. Some of those men will now see that you are not, because a lot of those of their men, they depend on their ladies. There is only few Nigerians that doesn't depend on their women. A lot of them depend on their women. That is the first thing that is breaking their homes. Yes. A lot, let me say 70% of Nigerian men depends on their women, because many of them are used to it. They are not good in working or in hustling or in catering for the family at all. But I don't understand. How can you call yourself a man when you cannot take the responsibility in your home as a man? You understand? That is not working at all, at all. What they will do now is that maybe you are pregnant. Now some will even try to push you out, to tell you to travel. Other countrymen will never allow their wife to travel outside to another country to go and give birth alone. Like the ones that Nigerian men are doing, sending their wives to Germany, to all parts of the Europe country. Other countrymen are not doing it, and they are not going to do it. No matter the condition that they are. If things goes wrong or things are fine, no, that same country that you got pregnant, they will be with you. And if it warrants for them to travel, for you to travel to other country, they will decide to even go with you. They will never allow you to go alone. And now, you will send your wife to another country to go and give birth. You know that you don't have house in that country. You don't have work there. You don't have anything. The poor woman, she's pregnant. And when she will go there now, she will just fall into the hands of all these government, you know, government thing of a thing. And some of those men will now even be pressing you to go because they feel that governments are paying. Since you cannot come with the income again because you are pregnant, you cannot work anymore, they prefer you to go and be receiving that shit, that chicken change, I call it, you know, money for bars. That chicken change, they prefer to send their loved one to go and be collecting it. And then I will be doing their own ways. Whereas it is very, very wrong. Tomorrow, when the government will take care of your, will take one of your children, what will you say? You will go and not give birth. They will ask you, where is your husband? You will say, your husband did not come with you. What is he doing in other country? You don't know. Some self will not even tell them that they even have boyfriend or they even have husband. They will tell them that they don't know who gave them pregnancy. So tell me, would that not even give these people 100% assurance that they can do anything to you or even take your child without anybody, you know, saying anything? That is very, very wrong. This is the hard time that we have to start thinking and know how to be controlling ourselves when we have quarrels with our husbands, you know. Sometimes we blame the women that they call the police so much, and they call the but some of their men are very, very heartless because the only thing that they know is to beat up their ladies, is to beat up their women. If you are living in a place that a Nigerian man have his wife, they are living together, all what you will hear is fight, quarrel every day. But in other country people, you will not even hear their voice. Some, if they have their problem, they will settle it amicably. Nobody will hear anything. But as for Nigerian people, that one, any man who is depending on his wife, he is not a human being at all. Many of them are doing it, and they are frustrating the women. Now, when the women now we go to that Germany now, they will not have no work, nothing to do. Some of them self will be even using that pregnancy to friend another guy. You understand? They will be using that pregnancy to friend another guy, whereby maybe they need something from that guy, maybe all these other country people, because Nigerian man, a lot of them will not give you. Yes, they will not give you. How many is working? It is the few ones that are working that know how to care for their family. Those ones know what brought them to Europe. But you see all those flying up and down ones, those ones that wear their trouser at their lap. Hey, if you go with those ones, you will suffer. I have even seen some lady whereby this particular lady, she abandoned everything that brought her to Europe. She abandoned her ambition coming to Europe. She just took pregnancy with this useless boy. And what the boy could say is that, let's go to Germany. Now the lady now arrived in Germany. She gave birth to her son there in Germany. Immediately, doctor tell the lady that, look, you have problem. You are not going to give birth anymore. Or maybe it is by the grace of God. Did you know what this man did? He just packed his bag and left the lady there with her child in Germany. He went back to wherever hellfire that he came from. Tell me, did you call that love? That is not love. Love is for both of you to stand together for better, for worse, for good or bad, rain or sunshine, no matter the condition. Even if she can, you only, some women that can even give birth through operations, something can develop in their body that they might not have the chance to give birth to another child again. But if you have a husband that loves you, he will still stick to you. Both of you are still going to work it together. Some that have the church mind will start praying and God will help them out. But some other useless men, they will just abandon you at the middle of that, especially when you are not getting money anymore. As we are talking to you right now, we have a sister that is in prison. This sister is in house arrest. This sister, when she never entered this particular prison, she was working. She was earning money a lot. House rent, feeding money, everything. She is the one that takes care of it. This one is that they even do marriage. Not that they are boyfriend and girlfriend. They're married together. So now, when the lady now have problem, she cannot work again because she was arrested, and thank God to her, they placed her on house arrest. This particular man, since there are many of them that are lazy, that depend on women, this particular man now started, the woman started irritating him. He will not even care for the woman. This particular woman, what I'm telling you now is that this woman is suffering now today. The man did not even send her anymore. For this woman to eat, It's very, very hard for her to even see food to eat in that particular house arrest because she's not making money anymore. The man forgot that the time that things are good, this woman was the one providing. Now that your woman have problem, what do you have to do as a real and a good man that love your wife? It's not for you to put yourself together and go and look for a job and care for the family. No. So tell me, Hadipin is not even has arrest. Maybe the lady now is pregnant, or maybe the lady gave birth to child. The child is still small. She cannot go work because the child never starts school. Which means that this particular man will still behave the same thing. He will even abandon you, whereby many of them will be depressed. What the next thing for them to do is to carry their ungongo and ungongo. Take it to government's house, go and stay there and be collecting little change. Some useless men at that self will still be collecting that little change from the government because of the children. Now they will still be dragging you as the woman to come and share that money with them. The money that they are paying for children to take care of themselves, for you to buy little things for the children, dress them fine, you know, everything that they need. Man will be asking you, will be dragging that money with you for you to come and share it. Is that fair? That is not fair. That is not fair. You see this single mother of 18, a lot of these Nigerian men are the cause. Yes, a lot of them are the cause. Even some of them that are not even married, that are even old till today, a lot of the Nigerian men are the cause, because what they do is this. When things are good with you, when you are working, when you are making that money, they will forget that you are even prostituting, for example, to get that money. They will be praising you. Ah, mama, everywhere. Mama, ah, mama, this, mama, that. You will buy them maca, buy them whatsoever they want. You pay their house rent, give them money for shopping, for whatsoever. That time, the love will be sweet. But immediately they see that maybe you are pressing them for marriage, you want to settle down, your age have moved forward, you want to settle down, so on and so forth. Some of them will say, who will marry this prostitute? Who will marry this ashawo? But you forgot that person was doing that prostitution to even feed you. She was doing that prostitution to even take care of you. Our people are really some of them are very, very difficult. They are difficult, and a lot of them are jealous shit, whereby they will not take care of you as the woman, but once you left them for another man, they will start fighting here and there. They will start causing havoc. Tell me, what will lead a man to beat your wife? Beating alone self is understatement. If a man beat his wife, that is normal. We normally hear that, you know, this one beat his wife, this one beat him. Now, it's the person that speak out, that tell you, that come to public to tell you, my husband beat me. That is what what you will know. But there are a lot of women that we have this simple altercation with their husband at home, but you will not hear it. But what will you gain? What is the need of you to be beating your wife? And that beating is not enough. What you will do is to carry bottle, carry knife, stab that woman to death, kill her for nothing's sake. That is very, very bad. It is very, very bad, because some of our men, their character in this Europe is very, very bad. Nigerian men, their character in Europe, they have to change it. Some are not even there to cater for the family or to take their responsibility as a man. All what they are there for is to cause havoc, just to destroy your life for nothing's sake. I don't say that women are perfect. There are some women that are also stubborn. Yes, I understand. There are some women that don't even respect also. I understand. But let me tell you that 80% to 90% of women, they are harmless. They are harmless. And when they tell you that they love you, they meant it when they said they love you. So many of these problems are coming from the men. Some of them will be seeing fine girls, white girls, black, this one, yellow, this one, this one, this one, this one. They will be leaving their wife at home. They will go outside to sleep with another girl. Some are not even catering for their wives. Yes, immediately they hear that, and maybe government is supporting you with this one, with this one. Instead of him to still put his hand in the pocket and still claim the responsibility as a man, he will say, after all, government is paying you. Then what do you want from me? Government is paying that woman for the children, to take care of the children. But you as a man now, you will still come up to still tell the woman that you want to sleep with her, whereby you are not taking care of that woman. You are not even giving her money to make her hair, giving her money to cook, giving her money to do nothing. But you will still want to sleep with her. Why can you sleep with her since you are not there to claim your responsibility? That is bad. Please, I advise you, as a lady, please, don't fall into this particular victim. Don't do it, please. If you see that you are in a very intoxicating relationship, whereby the man does not want to understand the meaning of responsibility, the meaning of real man, the meaning of father, please, just pack your things and leave that person. Yes, I am telling you, because the man that cannot cater for his family is never a man. A man that cannot take care of his wife and children is not a man. A man that cannot stand for you in the time of your need, or maybe when you are weak, is not a man. That is the real truth, and that is the real fact. And this heartless attitude is coming up from Nigerian men. I don't know if maybe it's because of the courtesies that they are, because many of them are courtesy. They are into courtesy, some of them. Yes, some of them are into courtesy. So I don't know if it is because of that initiative of the demons that they have in their brain. That is what they are using to manifest. Or maybe it is the drug they take, or maybe the drink, or whatsoever. They don't even want to reason that this is my wife, I have to respect my wife, being you is sunshine, being it rain. They don't even know that this is the mother of my child. I have to appreciate this particular woman because she suffers for me. She carry the pregnancy for 9 months. They will be saying, my child. Why some of them don't know what pains you feel of giving birth to that child during the pregnancy, even at the childbirth? Why some of them don't even know if the child will even eat, if the child will even dress? But they will go outside and be saying, my child. Any small giving thing, they will be saying, my child, you know. But they are not there for the children. That is very, very bad. We have to hold our anger. Not that people does not fight. People normally quarry. People normally fight. Teeth and tongue, they fight. Yes. A lot of... It's very, very difficult for you to be with someone for so many months together. And you will tell me that they will not be quarry. No matter what, they will be quarry. Yes. But for you as a man, it is wrong for you to raise your hand and beat your wife. And beat your girlfriend. Because why? She is powerless. Her vein and your vein is not the same. Remember that it is only with one vein of a man that God used to create woman. Meaning that you have extra 6 of them or 7 of them more than her. You have more strength, more power than her. And as a woman that have already given birth, she have lost a lot of strength also from there. You understand? So you have to mind the ways you are treating your wives at home. If quarrels arise like that, instead of you, if you see that you are somebody you cannot hold your anger, please, my brother, wear your shirt, wear your cloth, just come out. Come out for the house. Come out. Because if you are there, this one will be saying things that will provoke you. The other one will be saying things that will provoke you. Sometimes you will just pick something and hit that person. That person might die. Not that you don't love her, you love her, but because you cannot hold your anger, you will just kill her mistakenly, and now you will go to prison while she is dead. You will be regretting your life then. Please, if this kind of thing arises within you all, please, if you know that you are a man, you cannot hold your anger, you are a quick anger person, you know, you the quick the verse, I beg, bros, wear your clothes, come out. If you respect that woman, wear your clothes, come out for house. Just give her a few minutes, few hours for her to calm down. If she calm down, you can go back to her, say, baby, what is wrong? What is happening? Where do we have this problem? What is wrong? You know, try to find where the problems come from. Then you can unknow the solution to it. You see this mouth. Now this mouth, now the key person, now the safe person. This mouth when you see so. If you want this mouth to be sweet, it goes sweet well. But if you want, make this mouth, make it bitter, it go bitter. There is nothing like sweet mouth. Calm your woman down. She is your wife, she is your girlfriend for crying out loud. She loved you. She has been there for you, being rain or sunshine, no matter what. It is only the Nigerian women that I see that they can stand for their men. No, even if their man doesn't have shishi in their pocket, Nigerian woman can even sacrifice her life just because of her man. But a lot of Nigerian men cannot do that for their ladies. Why? Because of you men, other countries' people are insulting your women. I have said it in my last video. Yes, because why? You as a man, instead of you to stand up and take your responsibility, you will prefer to even be allowing that woman to be sleeping with other men and be collecting money. So tell me, if they see you tomorrow, what eye will they use to look you? Are they going to respect you? Are they going to call you a responsible person? That is why if you tell maybe all these white people that you are married as a Nigerian, they will just look at you, they will say, hey, these, you know, these people, we know them. Because some of them, they will be married and they will still be sleeping outside. And that is bad. You don't know that this thing or this particular thing, it normally brings bad luck to the house. Yes, it normally brings bad luck. Many of you don't know where you come from. A lot of African states, African countries, a lot of African people, they forbid a lot. There are things that you cannot do while you are with your man, either being it boyfriend or even husband. There are things that you cannot do because if you do it, it will affect you. If you do it, it will be bringing bad luck to that house and it might even cause death. Either maybe your child will die, your husband will die, or even you yourself will die. But if when they get to Europe, their men will forget all these things just in the name of money because some of them are lazy. The good ones are there. The good ones, yes, the good ones are there taking care of their wife, whereby nobody will even let their wife down. But those stupid ones, it's like they're just, I don't know if they were born like that. So because it is not one person, not to know. You will see in one particular state or one particular area from that Nigeria, 80% of their men are just fucking. There is nothing to write home about. It is better you don't even marry than to even go and date this kind of people. Because tomorrow what will happen is so disastrous, you know. As I am talking to you, I have a friend that even explained the problem to me. You see, this particular man, always there will be problem. Immediately he go to work and come home. Ah, the house will spark. And the woman will not have the opportunity to leave the house. This one will not allow the woman to leave the house. But when maybe Oyibo thing or something like that, he will allow the woman to go and collect money to come. You understand? But the problem is that this man will beat up this particular lady in front of her children. My God. That is the most painful thing. That is the most worst things that man can ever do. Beating up your wife in the presence of your children. White people, they don't play with that kind of nonsense. Even fighting self in the presence of your children self, they can even take away your children from you. Not to talk of beating your wife in the presence of your children. Every day, you will see that this woman have mark. This, she will just raise something, boy, 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 boy. Like say, the lady is a slave. Or maybe, I don't know, because had it been his sister, had it been he take that lady as his sister, he cannot touch that lady like that. He cannot beat that lady like that. Remember, you as a man, if one of your sister will come to you and tell you that my boyfriend beat me, my boyfriend do this to me, you know what will happen. You know what you will go and do to that particular man. Because I have experienced it, whereby if somebody even say nonsense or tell me anything, if I go and tell my brothers, the way they will disguanguan you, the way they will deal with you, you know that I have brothers, a lot of them. You understand? So you'll be fearing. So you now that will not allow somebody to beat your sister. You will be the one beating another person's sister, whereas you will even take the knife to stab her. Stab, stab. You know what is called stabbing, which means the hatred that you have for that person is more than the hatred you hate Satan. Because if you see Satan, say, I don't think you can stab Satan. Somebody that is living with you for so many years, that is preparing your food, washing your clothes, taking care of you and the children, giving birth to children, planning how the family will go forward, but due to the circumstances here and there that many of us don't have patience on. Because I have told you that in this Europe, things are hard, especially when you are married. Especially when you are married, things are very, very hard. Really, I am telling you, if you are working in a place that you are not receiving your salary regularly, or even you don't have work, my brother and sister, things will be very, very hard. But if you are not a patient body, both of you, there is no much love for you to cope together, to pass all this experience together, the marriage will fail. So please, my brothers, you all have to stop all these things. The killing is too much. It is too much. Nigerian girls are dying. They are losing their lives all in the name of boyfriend or husband. Imagine man that never even paid for your bride price. You don't even know your family. Don't know anything about you. Will just descend on you, be beating you, taking knife to stab you, doing all sort of nonsense. This is very, very wrong. We have to stop it. We have to stop it. I have said it today. Even if somebody said, I don't want again, it is not for you to go and kill that person or go and poison that person or set that person up. Try to work things out. This might change. If that person is really yours, it's going to come back to you to plead for forgiveness. But if that person is not yours, my dear, nobody will detect what will happen tomorrow except God. God can still bring another better person in your life. And you will move on. So it is very, very wrong for you to go and be killing other person. Maybe because they don't want you anymore. Maybe because they don't need you anymore. Maybe because something happened between both of you. You forgot the love that both of you played. You forgot where both of you knew each other. You forgot the time that both of you were suffering together. All what is in your mind is to just kill her. Let me just kill her. Let me just do this. Let me just do this. You forgot also where the consequences of killing somebody. What you will have. What you will bear after killing that person. You forgot all this. All what is in your mind now is to just let me do it because I'm a bagger. Let me do it because I'm this. Let me do it because I'm this. Please make una reduce all this una courtis character. You know good. You know they pay una carry una go anywhere. All this rugged character that both of you people are playing. Stop it. A lot of people, they are in court. A lot of African countries, they are in court, but they not carry their own put for head. But now, I go use my own so bag. Now, I go use and take so trouser. Now, I go use my own so shoe. And now, my wife head, now they pack all the whole go to put. For una mates, now, no go fit go fight. But now, my wife for house. If una drink rubbish finish, smoke nonsense finish, now, I can't descend on the poor women for house. I beg, make una they stop her. If you really want to settle down, be somebody that will be patient. Make you be somebody when go get soft mind. If you they get hot temper before, learn how to get sweet mouth. I beg, sweet mouth is too good. You feel calm anybody down. You feel even quench war when go even destroy the whole world because of this mouth of a thing. And you feel still cause war because of this mouth of a thing. If your wife do you something when you know wrong, when you not like that is wrong, call her, sit down. Say, mommy, look at what you did. I don't like this. Why did you do this? She also will still explain to her side of the story. She will still beg you if she wants to beg you. And that is it. A lot of Nigerian women, some of them, they respect a lot. They beg their husband. Some will be even kneeling down, begging themselves. You understand? But those men, hey, if you see the way they carry themselves, I have seen one woman in Napoli that years back, how many years back? You see the way this particular man is even he's even maltreating this woman. You think that the woman is shit. What does she do? What have she done to deserve all this? All in the name that she loved you. All in the name that she dropped all her ambitions. All in the name that she have given birth to children for both of you. That is why you will be taking her as a shit. You will just be looking at the woman. He saying, I see your belly too big. I beg go they do sport. I beg go they do this one. This man will even leave home in the morning. He will not come back up to the next day. He will be carrying small rats, small prostitutes here and there. What of tomorrow you carry STD, can't give your wife. You carry HIV, AIDS, can't give your wife. Waiting you go talk. Some of now when they carry, I'm a man, I be this one, I'm from royal home, I'm from royal kingdom. Babeg, make una they drop them. For Europe, you know they exist. You see how Igbo they do. Some of them, Igbo say their marriage not they last because if anybody do anyhow, they will just separate. That is how they do it. If you see all these Igbo, they respect their wife a lot. They respect them. Even Igbo said no, if you carry hand, say he raise on the wife. If he try him, that very day night the marriage they end. Yes. But for we African men, we go they do am. Our wife go they bear am. You go they bear am. Tomorrow it go better. Tomorrow my husband go change. Tomorrow this one. And make I bear am because now so our mommy is bear am back home. But still, una no go change. Una see they carry all that una big head. They thought they I be this one. I'm the man of the house. If you are the man of the house, my dear, claim the responsibility. responsibility, then you will get respect. You no go feel respect me when it be say na me they pay house rent, na me they feed you, na me they buy things for you. You no go respect me to come respect you. I can never respect. I go even they look like shit. It no go ever happen. Ah, it cannot happen, man. How can you tell somebody that is taking care of you to come and respect you? Now money be power. Who get money? Now you get power. Now you when it be say they give my money. Now you need to they respect me. Don't even they carry my bag, my hand post. They walk up follow me. Now so it they be. You understand? So if you want make your wife respect you, stand up as a man and claim your responsibility. Maybe say because say maybe things hard for you and only the woman they bring or the woman need to come they insult you. No, not that. If things hard for you, but you don't already they care for the family before, that woman go still continue to they respect you because you go remember say the time when you get, now you they take care of her, now you they take care of the children, now you they take care of the house. She go remember that one. She go no say really now because say, my husband not get money now, now I make the things be like this. That respect go ever stay there because she don't start that respect from the beginning when it be say you don't they take the responsibility. Maybe say you just come as a riffraff, as a junkie or what. Whatsoever. Enter person life, you not carry money come, you not carry anything come, they go break. Instead of man to walk, to dress and go to work, you they expect woman to go work. You won't be man sit down for house. Who you now? You be the wife now. What where you won't forget respect for them? Make una the reason now. I beg, make una not the key una women again. In all goods. You know, go feel pay. Oh, my name don't too spoil. Oh, my name, Nigerian men self. Even when they see them now, they look they're like mafia, like bad people. Because Nigerian men don't get respect for their wife. They don't get respect for anybody. That they look anybody like see if they be tattered, you know. But if you meet all these other African countries, if you see the way that they respect their wives, the woman say go even they even don't say the man not get one kobo. Just because the way when the man say they carry her, she go even mellow down. Nobody go hear their words. You understand? So that is the way it's supposed to be. Let me say, because say we love each other, because say we love each other, then now one person will become slave, the other one will become human being. You know they work like that. If you need respect, you need to deserve it, you know. It make you deserve, and the way to deserve that respect, you need to stand up as a man. Man deserve respect. Why not? Man deserve respect. That is why they call them man. But not all men deserve respect. Those that are responsible to care for their family are the ones that deserve that respect. But those ones when it be say now show money they want chop, who won't respect you now? Those ones now show still they play. So you know what, I'm a beg all this German of Germany of 18, make you know they carry on too much for. See if you things they hard for you, say your life don't tire for Germany, you know, see go come, you know, go back to your country where you come from. Remember that when you there for that country, you know they suffer like that. Go back, start from afresh, start to they pick your life together, things go better for you. Instead when you go sit down for there just though they do anyhow, some now they will even dump their children, they will still go and look for a hustle because there is no man to care for them. The man was supposed to care for them, he don't push them, push their property, tell them say make that they go. Now then go even buy tickets, give and save. They carry ticket, give you, say make you they go, make government tell they take care of you. Then in now you go just the zero for street, they do what you want do, they carry women, they go, they carry Oyibo, they carry black, they carry this one. Tomorrow you go say he be father, tomorrow you go say he be responsible man. It don't, no, you know they work like that. I beg, if you be person when they vest too much and they beg you, if you be person. See all these women are caught when they carry the poop for, because now this court is of 18, since when this court is of 18 come, now in Nigerian men turn to pure finish. Some of them say they know they even they know what they do again, because now that spirit, that evil spirit of court is don't enter their brain. So anything when they appear for their presence, now demon. Make una know they carry court for head again, I beg, because you know they pay anybody. You understand? Not the thing say you be number one, you be number two, you be number three. Then you won't come keep person to show say you be number one. Who are you? Now you be God, then they give life. Make una know they do one. Because anybody when kill, una know where they go. 20 years prison go up, 30 years, 50 years, some na life imprisonment. Do you know what it meant to be in prison? Unless you never go there. If you don't enter Yoko City, and now you go no say na Yoko City, my dear. If you enter there, you go even they regret why you come that kind of place. You understand? You go even they beg us, say if you get opportunity to come out, you know, do that thing again. But it is too late to cry when the head is off. Learn how to calm down with your wife. Women are so lovely. Women are soft. Especially any woman, when she carry belle for you, born your pekin,
Ah, my dear, respect that woman. That woman no hates you, no matter the condition. Maybe now one kind situation or the other, now you may go make crayfish go bend. But I tell you, say that woman love you. If you don't love you, 3 months pregnancy, you no go carry and pass her. If you too much, make it be 3 months, she go come out time. Because if you hate man, you don't know how pregnancy they make person they feel. You go even hate yourself. Talk less if when you hate that man, that baby no go stay. You go come out time. But if you get the mind to hold that pikin pass that month till you born him, I beg, remember say that woman love you, no matter the condition. And the ways when I think they push our children into the hands of all these people, when we say, when they even adopt them, no, they see those children again, or not, they don't know what they use them for. No, I don't know whether they go, they even, they tear their parties, they sell, they take, they train, he cure other people. No, I don't know whether they use them as sex slave. No, I don't know whether they even, they use them as anything. Come up here, go and sleep. Oh yeah, move. Go. See them there. No, 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 whether they use them as anything, but no, go just push my wife, come out. They go that side, push my children, come out. Make una they stop them. Make una they stop them. If you know, say you never, you know, go fit take care of child, you know, say you never get any important when you they do work, never they. I beg, if you they meet woman, use rubber, cover yourself. You hear? Not the hope saying a government now they go take care of your children, because you not go know waiting go fit come up tomorrow. Whether they go even collect that children from your hand and you not go see them forever and ever again. Because our children are suffering. Our children are suffering. Our ladies are suffering. Please, Nigerian men, stop this no character. This one now when don't kill this in wife now for Germany. The poor woman don't go be that one. This one go teach a lot of lesson. Say I beg next time if you get altercation with my wife, make una they calm down. I beg, nothing pass, I beg, life don't continue be that. Now woman now she be, remember say now your sister, the way when you take commode for house, that is the same way that woman left Africa also, you understand? She is your body, she is your sister, she has given her soul, her life, her body for you. So please respect that and also try to save her life instead of taking their life. So thank you all for watching, my lovely people. Make una try share this with this particular information and make una give advice to our men, because the way when they think they do for Europe, water don't pass Gario. Respect not there again. No understand. So that is it. Thank you all and remain blessed. Bye for now.